drifting farther along the sunlight, you caught beneath the grass and fern a subtle straight perfume. It reached the twirling cigar, the funeral in the bullet. The rattle of the busy life had choked the whisper down. Some had caught a fresh brown breeze with scent of pines.
They later took on the name Pines in honour of the father of Australian Federation, Sir Henry Pines. Today, Pines is a bustling and prosperous district, sitting in rich farming soil. The green of gold has given way to the green of agriculture. The area supports over 15,000 people, and it's growing steadily. And it has the famous Pipe's Dish, a powerful radio telescope that peers deeply into the skies of the Southern Hemisphere. To learn the history and the latest about the dish, let's meet with Christopher Hobbiton. Christopher, what led to the building of the radio telescope here at Pipe's? And now is it built in the middle of a farm?
First of all, back in the 1950s, with the race on who build large dishes. England, they were first, and they built some large dishes around the size of this one. But they had some problems because they jumped in a bit too quick. So it came our time to build one. We took our time, planned it well, and then we went ahead and built this dish and done it well. We'll go and see what that done. So yeah, it was built in 19, it finished in 1961. Really useful because of its large size. And if you can get a signal, it's going to be